come on over to my house. Here, kitty, kitty, here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Itty bitty kitty, catch me a little bitty mouse. There's a great big shotgun hanging on the wall. There's a great big shotgun hanging on the wall. When you shoot that mouse, he'll jump, holler and squall. Now here, kitty, kitty, here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Here, kitty, kitty, here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Itty bitty kitty, catch me a little bitty mouse. He's done got too old. That old tomcat, he's done got too old. He can't catch a mouse, he's done got too slow. Now here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Oh, Xander, you better pick it, man. Oh, yeah. Don't you do me no wrong. I love you, honey. Don't you do me no wrong. You're gonna wake up and find your big cat gone. Now here, kitty, kitty, here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Here, kitty, kitty, come on over to my house. Itty bitty kitty, catch me a little bitty mouse.
Thank you guys so much. How's the sound out there? Is it okay? I will take just a little bit more lead vocal in my monitor if you can give it to me. I would appreciate that. All right, let's not delay. Let's get right down to the hillbilly.
Do it.
We're going to do a little thing right now, a Marvin Rainwater song called Get Off the Stool.
One, two, three.
I walked into a cafe. I was feeling mad and low. Could have ate most anything, but I didn't have no dough. Then a pretty little waitress stared at me, and then I heard her say, get off the stool, you silly fool. You can't sit there all day. And I said, why? She said, 'cause this ain't no place to take a rest, and I ain't Santa Claus. So I walked into a tavern. I didn't have a cent. The bartender just looked at me, said, bud, you're badly bent. Now we don't care for moochers, and we don't furnish shade. Get off the stool, you silly fool, come back when you get paid. And I said, why? He said, 'cause this ain't no place to take a rest, and I ain't Santa Claus. Well, I went to see my baby just the other night. She asked me for a little kiss. It filled my heart with fright. She puckered up her painted lips. I said, leave me alone. Get off the stool, you silly fool. You might as well go home. And I said, why? She said, 'cause this ain't no place to take a rest, and I ain't Santa Claus. She had a Jersey cow. Sent me to do the milking. She thought that I knew how. I sat right down in front of Jersey with her. She walked in. Get off the stool, you silly fool. Get on the other end. And I said, why? She said, 'cause this ain't no place to take a rest, and I ain't Santa Claus. I was speeding down the highway, when someone hollered stop. Kept right on a going, I didn't know it was a cop. He sat me down before the judge. He said, you'll change your ways. Get off the stool, you silly fool. You're here for 30 days. And I said, why? He said, call. You find a place to take a rest. I'll be your Santa Claus. You find a place to take a rest. I'll be your Santa Claus.
Thank you so much. Is it too early for our Hillbilly of the Night segment?
A little bit. Maybe, I mean...
I don't know. It's only the third song, but I'm ready to go with this. No. This is a prepared segment. I'm not going to do it about one of our paying members of the audience. Every show, we feature a famous hillbilly, and we feature him that evening. So tonight's Hillbilly of the Night is also the person whose song that we're going to sing next. Talking about the great Johnny Bond. How many people are familiar with Johnny Bond?
Yeah!
Is that James' brother?
Not James Bond's dad, yeah. Sadly.
Here's a Johnny Bond album cover. Now, Johnny Bond had a long career. He had a lot of hits. He had a hit record with Hot Rod Lincoln. You guys remember that song. But he also had a big, long spell of his career where he was known for songs about alcoholic beverages and drunks. Including this song we're going to do next, Sick, Sober, and Sorry. That's right. But I have to tell a little special interest story because I know that we have some record collectors here in the audience. This is back in the early 1990s. I moved to Burbank, and I lived on Keystone Street in Burbank. And I'm not sure how, but somehow or another, I found out that Johnny Bond had once lived a block away from me, right? Over on Lincoln Street. And I rode by the house and I thought, oh, that's so cool. That's where Johnny Bond lived. Now, some of you who follow my posts on Facebook and Instagram and all that, you may know that I'm a bit of a hoarder. Like really cool stuff, right? And you may ask, Deke, how did you get that way? Why did you become like that? Well, let me tell you a story. So I found out that Johnny Bond lived on Lincoln Street, just a block away from where I lived. Never once thought, maybe Johnny Bond's widow still lives there. Never once even occurred to me. But we went up and played in San Francisco one weekend. We were gone all weekend. And when I got back, this is back in the days before texts, kids, and emails and all that. When I got back from that trip, my answering machine was loaded with messages. Dude, I'm over at Johnny Bond's estate sale. Why aren't you here? There's 10,045s and they're a dime a piece. Where are you? Johnny Bond's widow had not a single-length garage, not a double-length garage. It was literally a triple-length garage. It was about as long as this tent, and it was filled with 45 RPM records. And they were all 10 cents each. And I missed the sale. So now whenever you see my posts and I'm like, I scrounged through all this stuff because I had to find out if there was anything good there. It's because of that sale. Because I missed Johnny Bond's estate sale. That's a very sad story, isn't it? Well, you should see all the junk I've managed to accumulate since then. Then you wouldn't feel so bad. Now it's turned into a situation where people are like, hey man, is Deke sick? Is he gonna have an estate sale? So let's do a little Johnny Bond famous number right now called Sick, Sober, and Sorry. And you guys are gonna help me with this, aren't you?
Here we go. One, two, three.
Sick, sober, and sorry. Disgusted and sad. Sick, sober, and sorry. But look at the fun that I had. I met with a gal in a tavern. Oh, what a beautiful dream. We had three or four, then
had several more, and that's when I went off my bean. Sick, sober, and sorry. Broke, disgusted, and sad. Sick, sober, and sorry. But look at the fun that I had. The jukebox so loudly was playing. Each couple was having a ball. But all of them gals, their sweethearts and pals, I bet I'm the sickest of all. Sick, sober, and sorry. Broke, disgusted, and sad. Sick, sober, and sorry. But look at the fun that I had. The clock on the wall said it's later. It was 20 to 4. In spite of my pride, they kicked me outside. They locked and they bolted the door. Sick, sober, and sorry. Broke, disgusted, and sad. Sick, sober, and sorry. But look at the fun that I had. That's a brand new Whippersnappers performance for you.
Nice.
We've been trying to have, you know, at least 4 or 5 new songs every time that we come down here and play Campus Jacks, because we don't want to do the same show every time. Oh, we're going to get around to our big hit in just a minute. But we can't play it too early in the set, because we know that you'll leave as soon as we play it. So you got to wait around through some of these filler songs first.
It's like a quiet riot show. Come on, Illinois.
All right, here's one that that I recorded on one of my CDs a while back. It's called Broken Heart. Sorry, I told you a lie. For if you ever leave me, I would be left alone to die. Broken heart, I have gone and I've broken your heart. Broken heart in so many. Thank you guys very much.
Nice.
All right, let's do a Ray Price song now. What do you say? We got some Ray Price fans out there. This is a good one of his. It's a nice up-tempo hillbilly song. To differentiate between the other up-tempo hillbilly songs that we do. Do we do any medium-tempo ones? I guess that last one was kind of medium-tempo,
yeah,
right?
Medium, yeah.
This is a little thing called Who Stole That Train? Who stole that train on the track? Who stole that choo-choo that was bringing baby back? Is someone playing jokes on me? They better let my baby be. Oh, who stole that train off the track? My baby wrote and said that she was coming home on 93. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Been waiting here since early morn. That thief was here, but now she's gone. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Well, who stole that train off the track? Took it, better come and put it back. If someone played jokes on me, they better let my baby be. Oh, who stole that train off the track? I looked and saw a cloud of steam. I plainly heard a whistle scream. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Looked again with all my might, but still no engine come inside. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Who stole that train on the track? Who stole that choo-choo that was bringing baby back? Somebody must have pulled the switch and run a train into a ditch. Oh, who stole that train on the track? Looked up yonder in the sky and saw the smoke rising high. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Smoke was hanging in the air, but ain't no baby anywhere. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Well, who stole that train off the track? Whoever took it better come and put it back. My baby wouldn't make me wait. She'd walk home if the train was late. Oh, who stole that train off the track? Thank you so much. Nice. All right, we haven't played this next song for a couple of these shows, so let's bring it back for this next one. It's an old Webb Pierce number called Walking the Dog.
One, two, three. I'm a walking the dog. I'm a walking the dog. I ain't thinking about you. I don't need no one to tie me down. And I'm a walking the dog. And I'm painting the town. Such an easy life I never knew until the day but I'm a carefree lad that's seen the light. And I'm a walking the dog all the day and all pep. I just can't grow old. I got a one-track mind, so I've been told. But I'm a fancy freak, I don't worry no how. I'm just a walking the dog, all the law will allow. Such an easy life I never knew. We're really through. Well, I'm a carefree lad that's seen the light, and I'm a walking the dog all the day and all night.
Oh, we got a new one here, and I gotta use my tremolo pedal. I don't normally use any effects at all, but this song, it needed one.
The tremolo.
This is a very special tremolo made for me by a friend in Canada. It's called the Hypno Trem. And when you press the button, the eyes start flashing. Mm. It's a very neat one. But now I gotta make sure that I actually step on it at the right time. I don't like effect pedals. Mostly because I'm just not good enough to use them.
You're breaking my heart, Deke.
This one would be good for a Halloween show, but we're going to do it here tonight anyway. It's a little thing called A Visit from the Devil. You guys ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three.
A few short hours ago, I went and walked this world away. But now 6 feet below the earth in a coffin cold lay. They lowered me into this grave, filled the sod up level. But now I wait for my hellish fate, a visit from the devil. Oh, devil, why do you torment me? My soul belongs to thee. Well, I see you there, and you're standing there, that pitchfork's aimed at me. Why did you have to come so soon, not prepared to travel? The way I've lived my life, I've earned a visit from the devil. Table stands where we dealt our hands for that game of poker. I held two aces and I drew three chords, a deuce, a queen, a quarter. I held my aces in one hand, my best girl in the other. But the best hand held a 44 and it belonged to her brother. Devil, why do you torment me? My soul belongs to thee. Well, I see you there, but your hands ain't bare, that pitchfork's aimed at me. Why did you have to come so soon? I'm not prepared to travel. The way I've lived my life, I've earned a visit from the devil. I saw old Satan grin at me as I saw that 44. His eyes beckoned me to come on in as he opened up his door. The visit from the devil now leads me to believe that it was he who pulled that fifth ace from my sleeve. Oh, devil, Why do you torment me? My soul belongs to thee. Well, I see you there, but your hands ain't bare. That pitchfork's aimed at me. Why did you have to come so soon? I'm not prepared to travel. The way I've lived my life, I've earned a visit from the devil.
Thank you very much. And now I got to get this pedal out of the way or I'm going to accidentally be stepping on it all night.
It might sound cool, you know, you never know. You never know. Maybe that's just what the hillbilly songs needed all this time. Is, experimental. Yeah, a little bit of tremolo.
You guys have seen these boots, right? That's the problem. I got these big pointy boots. I'm just stepping on my effects pedals if they're anywhere close. I was talking about, you know, being a hoarder. And this guy that I haven't seen in a really long time, a guitar player friend of mine, he said, you know, I've got all these old decorative whiskey decanters. Would you like them? And I thought to myself, those would make excellent prizes for the Hillbilly Fest show at Viva Las Vegas. So I went, you know, and I really haven't hung out with anybody this last year. So I went over to his place, and he had these old whiskey decanter bottles. And I guess he's seen some of these videos that I've been posting on social media and things. And anyway, as we were walking to my car with these whiskey decanters, he goes, you know, man, I forgot that you were such a big dude. I said, yeah. He says, you know, walk around with a pair of red patent leather boots like that with jewels on the heels, as big as you are, that takes some balls, man. I said, well, thanks, I guess. Hadn't actually thought about it until he said that.
Where are we at?
No more Saturday night. All right.
No more.
Here's a song that I wrote about our pandemic time. And, you know, like I said, we normally play all the time and have gigs, but for us musicians to not have any gigs. So I wrote this song. This is my pandemic song. It's called No More Saturday Night. Of course, we're out here partying on a Saturday night tonight. And hopefully with all the vaccinations and everybody feeling safe to go out and all that, we'll get back to rocking sometime soon this year, I'm hoping. But for now, this is the song that I wrote about middle of last year. Ready?
Yeah.
One, two, three. I had a date with my baby, but I can't go. I can't go out and see a picture show. I tried everything, but the answer is no, 'cause there's no more Saturday night. I was home on Monday, and I stayed in. Tuesday and Wednesday I was home again. Well, how I wish someone would be my friend, 'cause there's no more Saturday night. There's no more Saturday night. No more Saturday night. Well, there ain't no sun or blue sky inside now. There's no more Saturday night. Well, I went to the kitchen just to make me a bite. Went down the hallway to the room on the right. I passed the little room with the throne of white, but there's no more Saturday night. I went out in the yard and I mowed some grass. Sat on the porch and watched the cars go past. I'm not sure how long I'm gonna last, but there's no more Saturday night. There's no more Saturday night. No more Saturday night. Just looking for a sign, but that 'cause there's no more Saturday night.
Oh, yeah.
Right on.
Thank you so much. Now, friends, how about these whippersnappers? These guys are good, aren't they? I always feel so lucky to play with these guys because, man, I think they're great. And so I'd like to feature them right now. First up, Mr. Bert Avalos. And you've picked out something different that we have not done here at Campus Jacks.
Mm-hmm.
All right.
So it's either going to go really good or it's going to go a different way. So
just go crazy, man, and they won't know the difference.
Okay. I want to take my arms, wrap them around your frame, kiss your lips and change your name. Oh, baby. Settle down with you, lock my heart and live so true. Oh, baby, yeah, baby. Ooh, baby, you look that good to me. I love you loving ways as a natural fact. Take my heart, don't give it back. Ooh, baby, yeah, baby. Ooh, baby, you look that good to me. Do it together. Get back to you. Oh, baby. Yeah, baby. Ooh, baby. You look that good to me. Do it, Sandy. Shine to you, oh baby, yeah baby, ooh baby, you look the best good to me.
Yeah. Nice. Give it up for Bert Avalos, y'all.
Thank you.
Now I mention this every time, but I will say it again. Bert plays with a couple other bands, the Moontones and the Centuries, and his Roberto one-man band.
Yeah, the one-man band.
Occasionally. Yeah. But no, one more time, give it up for Bert.
Thank you.
And now we're going to pass it over here to Mr. Xander Griffith, y'all.
Let's do it.
And, you know, he wrote a brand new song, which we're happy to debut here tonight.
Thanks for playing my song.
One, two.
They call him Firecracker, and the man with shining teeth. If you think you see him coming, you better cross the street. He came to California from the deep and dirty south. His caddy and his guitar, his ever-moving mouth. He's a man full of pride. He keeps running for his life. Tall and thin, no stranger to sin. The one called Golden Grip. Enchanted by a witch. He's been up, he's been down, he's been poor and rich. He'll tell you of his travels to England, France, and Spain, but never of his struggles, how he pushes down the pain. He's a man full of pride. He keeps running for his life. Tall and thin, no stranger to sin, the one called. Yeah!
For Xander, y'all, and his brand new song, The Man with the Golden Grin. Yeah. All right, I'm going to switch to the six-string bass for a few songs now.
Oh, yeah.
What's your game, Deke? You're trying to steal my job? Two more strings? You think you're better than me?
I mean...
Okay, maybe you're better than me.
Okay, we're going to do a couple of Johnny Horton songs here.
Good.
And I think I've gone into my rap here before. I think Johnny Horton has even been our hillbilly of the night. But he had a big hit, Battle of New Orleans. Remember that song? And we'd like to do some of his more obscure rockabilly and hillbilly material right now. But I'll just tell a real quick story that I'm not going to go into the whole story because I've told it here before. But I have Johnny Horton's stereo in my living room and a couple of Johnny Horton photographs up on the wall above it, right? It's his personal stereo. And when we're in there rehearsing this last week, it's freaky, man. We do these songs and it's like Johnny Horton's looking at us from his promo photos.
Yeah.
Like, so let's try to do him justice, all right, boys?
Okay. Here we go. Sugar-coated baby.
When the last soul flicker of the sun goes down, they turn their lights on all over town. That's when you'll see me walking broad and main. I'm gonna go see my sugar-coated babe. I'm just like a kitten playing with a string. When I'm a-holding that pretty little thing, she's as sweet as honey all the way around, and she's sugar-coated all the way down. Well, I'm drowning myself in her eyes of blue, 'cause each and every kiss is just like brand new. I bet when you find me, I'll be nestled in her arms, having myself a lost a weekend of charms. Just like a kitten playing with a string, when I'm a-holding that pretty little thing, she's as sweet as honey all the way around, as she's sugar-coated all the way down. Love's a good for nothing, it don't come on a cup. It comes from her heart and I'll never get enough. She kisses me, it's like a drink of wine. It warms me all over just to know that she's mine. I'm just like a kitten playing with
with a string. When I'm a-holding that pretty little thing, she's as sweet as honey all the way around, and she's sugar-coated all the way down.
Oh, yeah. Now, somebody was asking for this next song. This is our big hit, yeah. Wild, Wild Thing. How many of you have seen our new professionally shot video that we just released for this? I am really excited about this because, you know, all these years that I have been playing music, I really haven't done just a handful of professionally shot videos, and I haven't done one in a really long time. For those of you who haven't seen it, go check it out. It's on YouTube. Wild, Wild Thing with Deke and the Whippersnappers. But I'll tell you a little bit of the story behind it. I have this 1960 Cadillac at home, okay? And it's a cool car. It's a very cool car. But it kind of just barely runs and drives. It's one of those kind of cars. It's a fun car. And so Bert laughs because he knows what I'm talking about.
It's a fun car.
It's a fun car. It's not a show car. So I asked this friend of mine, Spike Marble, to shoot the video. He's been doing some really, really nice photography and video lately, and I thought he would do a great job. And I was thinking, you know, man, he lives in Costa Mesa. I'm not sure that my Cadillac is going to make it all the way to Costa Mesa. I live up in the valley, right? So I asked him where he's thinking about shooting, and he said, well, I did a shoot kind of up near Castaic, up near Magic Mountain. I thought, well, that's not too far away. Right, it's like 23 miles from my house. So he gives us this location, and we get there and get off the freeway, and there's these signs that say, no trespassing, not a public road, and we're looking at each other like, well, let's just go for it. I mean, this is where he said he did a shoot before. So we start going up this road, and, you know, it's a gravel road, and I'm a little bit bummed out about taking my nice 1960 Cadillac on this gravel road. Finally, we meet up with Spike in this little wide area, and he says, well, I think if we go up just like another mile, there's like a really nice vista up there where we can shoot. It's just a really beautiful overlook. I said, okay, that sounds good. And these guys and Michelle, we can all attest that that last mile all of a sudden became this gutted out, like, fire road, one lane, steep drop-off to the left. There's no gravel or dirt or anything. It's just kind of like ruts. I'm not sure anybody had been up there in a long time. And I'm in my 60 Cadillac and go way down this hill, then way up this hill, way down this hill, way up this hill. Finally, we get to this thing where we're going to shoot this video. And it really, really did look great, I have to say. But we all this time, we're looking at this road that we had to leave on, right? And I'm just thinking, I gave the guitars to Spike to put in his car. I said, okay, this may turn into like an accidental Thelma and Louise. It's a convertible, so we can just hop out. Like, if this thing starts going off the side, I was telling Bert and Xander, like, just jump, okay? Just think about how many, there's going to be time for one grab and then one step for you to get out of the car if this thing goes over. And you can see, if you watch this video, right at the very end, because Spike had a drone that he's flying over us as we're going on this road. And it's just, this Cadillac is just bumping. And I have no idea how we got out of there. But we did. I never let up on the gas, not once. Oh. Kind of like this talk right now. I'm not allowing any silent moments in this.
Well, I just wish that we had that footage, because he set up a little camera inside of the Cadillac. And we're like rolling down this dirt road looking all cool. And then we hit this bump, and we're just, oh! Because yeah. The bottom of the car just,
yeah, it was bad.
That was awesome.
He said there was a lot of that footage from the camera inside the car that he couldn't use because of the look on my face. Just a pained look on my face. But anyway, if you haven't seen the video, check it out. We're very proud of it. And this is kind of like our breakout song from our new 7-inch EP that you can buy here tonight. It's a little thing called Wild, Wild Thing. I've been in this business a long time, and I know when people are clapping because I've finally stopped talking.
Here we go. One, two, three.
Yeah.
I was born on the breeze, raised beneath the trees, and the night the courthouse burned, they lost my name. I've got hot blood inside this mountain of pride, and you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Go tell your mama you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. I've got memories so unkind, there's scars on my mind. Cheating women and good booze are all I sing. I'll hurt you till you cry, and I'll ramble till I die, and you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Go tell your mama you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Well, I never knew my dad. Sister, she went bad. Started from good seed, but got swallowed by the weeds. Go tell your mama you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Of your fancy city lights, 'cause it's just another country town to me. I'll put on my walking shoes, and I'll leave you with the blues, 'cause you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Go tell your mama you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Well, I never knew my dad. Sister, she went bad. Started from good seed, but got strung out by the weeds. Go tell your mama you're fooling with a wild, wild thing. Go tell your mama fooling with a wild, wild thing. Thank you very much. A wild, wild thing. And now we're going to do another Johnny Horton song for you, because we just can't get enough of the six-string bass and little Johnny Horton. And I'm going to send this out to a good friend of ours, Corky Wallen, in Grandview, Wisconsin, who's out there watching tonight. We're going to send this one out to Corky. Here we go. Squeaking, the guitars are speaking, the piano plays a jelly roll. The man on the drums is far from dumb, and the bass man, he plays from his soul. The tables are quaking and your nerves are shaking, but you keep on begging for more. You keep a having your fun, you lucky son of a gun, on the honky-tonk hardwood floor. On a honky-tonk hardwood floor. On a honky-tonk hardwood floor. You keep a-having your fun, you lucky son of a gun, on the honky-tonk hardwood floor. There's a waitress handy, and she don't sell candy, and she don't sell soda pop. Oh, there's a fat bartender that'll serve you if you really want to blow your top. If you got no money, well, there's a little honey, she's a gal that you adore. So keep a-having your fun, you lucky son of a gun, on the honky-tonk hardwood floor. On the honky-tonk hardwood floor. On the honky-tonk hardwood floor. You keep
people having your fun, you lucky son of a gun on the honky-tonk hardwood floor. The payday's Saturday, you're broke on Sunday. On Monday, you're feeling sore. You got two black eyes that you picked up from a little guy the night before. So you swear off the drinking, but when you get to thinking about the good times you had galore, you keep a having your fun, you lucky son of a gun, on the honky-tonk hardwood floor. On the honky-tonk hardwood floor. On the honky-tonk hardwood floor. You keep a having your fun, you lucky son of a gun, on the honky-tonk hardwood floor.
Thank you so much. Is everybody still having a good time? All right. That's what we like to hear. And you know, it's still, man, it takes some getting used to, because even after a year, it's still weird to not play a song like that and not have just the dance floor filled with people dancing. It's strange. But anyway, let me get my regular guitar back on. We're playing another dancing song now, aren't we? Somebody I talked to here tonight was there. Do you remember that last gig that we did before the pandemic hit? We played at the Grand Ole Barbecue down in San Diego. And it was just the greatest gig ever. It was perfect temperature, barbecue, everybody was dancing. It was just an awesome night. And at the end of the gig, Xander here talked the Topo Chico promo people into giving me 4 cases of Topo Chico, which was like the best gig ever, man. Besides tonight, of course.
I got a guy.
But anyway, I remember playing this little Western swing number that day, and just a sea of people dancing to it, and I hope that we get back to doing that soon. Here's a little thing called Tulsa Baby.
Well, I've got troubles on my mind since I left my loving baby behind in the good old state of OKLA. Oh, when she's walking down the street, the cats all yell, she's all reach. She hails from a town called TULSA. Now, if you could see, I bet you'd agree, she's the sweetest thing in town. When she smiles, I'm telling you, makes my head go round and round. Well, I'm going back to see my baby. To stay away is gonna drive me crazy. I can't get my mind off that Tulsa baby. I'm a going home. I promised her that I'll never roam from the good old state of OKLA. For when she's walking down the street, the cats all yell that she's all reach. She hails from a town called TULSA. Now I just received her telegram. Seems like a crazy dream. Said, come on back to old T-Town and bring your wedding ring. So soon I'll be down on 4th and Denver. I promised her that I will never, never, never leave my Tulsa baby.
Thank you. Oh, yeah, Tulsa baby. Yeah. Now we're going to do another song that the Whippersnappers wrote. This is on our 7-inch EP that you can buy here tonight. I also want to say a big thanks to Summer out there at the door for running the merchandise. Thank you very much. And in case you're not familiar with the system that we're doing now, we have like a merchandise order form, and you can write down what you want, and you can give it to Summer, and she'll dig it out to you and deliver it to your table. So please buy lots of merchandise.
A lot.
Yeah, we... Thank you. Thank you very much. But anyway, this is a song that the boys wrote. It's on our EP, and it goes like this.
My baby loves her rock and roll, got that kind of style. Get her on the dance floor, really drives her wild. Crazy for the guitar, really digs the drums. Get her to a party, look out, here she comes. She's gonna shake her hips, she's gonna clap her hands, gonna show them rocking like they never had. Well, this girl's gone rocking, rocking, and she don't know how to stop. Slow it down, baby, you're moving way too fast. Night's still young, gonna make it last. You and me, baby, gonna have our fun. Won't stop bumping till we see the sun. She's gonna shake her hips, she's gonna clap her hands, gonna show them rocking like they never had. Well, this girl's gonna rockin', rockin', and she don't know how to stop. She's gonna shake her hips, she's gonna clap her hands, gonna show them rockin' like they never had. Well, this girl's gonna rockin', rockin', and she don't know how to stop. She don't know how to stop. Well, this girl's gone rockin', rockin', and she don't know how to stop.
Oh, yeah.
Oh, good.
And now we'd like to do another song that's on that 7-inch EP. This is an instrumental little thing for the lovers out there. A mucho.
Thank you.
Oh, thank you so much. Besame mucho. All right, we're going to do another brand new song. We've never done this one before. We're going to dedicate this one to our drummer. Yeah, it's a little thing called You're So Dumb. Well, come to me, mama, see what you done. Put the sheep in the meadow and the cows and the corn, cause you're so dumb. Yeah, you're so dumb. I can tell right now, you ain't no good for me. Well, you lied to your ma and you lied to your pa, lied to your preacher and you lied to the law, cause you're so dumb. Yeah, you're so dumb. I can tell right now, you ain't no good for me. Well, I think you need schooling, you got so much to learn. You're so doggone greasy, baby, I know you'll never burn. Cause you're so dumb, yeah, you're so dumb. I can tell right now, you ain't no good for me. Okay. Said I got your heart, but you can't fool me, mama, cause I'm way too doggone smart. Cause you're so dumb, yeah, you're so dumb. I can tell right now, you ain't no good for me. Well, I think you need schooling, you got so much to learn. You're so doggone greasy, baby, I know you'll never burn. Cause you're so dumb, yeah, you're so dumb. I can tell right now, you ain't no good for me. You're so dumb. Now, I really wanted to do that last song just for one line in there. I don't know if you guys caught it or not. I think you need schooling. You got so much to learn. You're so doggone greasy, baby. I know you'll never burn. Now, that is hillbilly right there. You have to actually live in the country where you burn your own trash to even understand that line. Right? See, nobody here even gets it, right? I grew up in Missouri. We used to burn our trash. All right, let's move on here.
What do we got next here? Oh, wait, no, too much damage.
Oh, that's right. How we doing? I got to check my time because I'm having so much fun here. I might be playing too long. No, we got plenty of time. Here's a little thing called Too Hot to Handle. Hot to handle, I know it's no use. Like a hot potato, I'm turning you loose. Well, I'm just a country boy, and it's plain to see you're too hot to handle for me. You walk down the sidewalk and you think you're so hot. You think you got something that you haven't got. Well, I don't mind hog eating, and I ain't the hog. I don't mind some dogging if I ain't the dog. You walk down the sidewalk and you think you're so hot. You think you've got something that you haven't got. I don't mind hog eating if I ain't the hog. Don't mind some dogging if I ain't the dog. You're too hot to handle, you're too cold for love. You're too money hungry to be my turtle dove. The high cost of romance is a killing me. You're too hot to handle for me. Oh, thank you very much. Now, I have to send, this is just an introduction. I'm not dedicating this next song, but I have to send an introduction out to my beautiful girlfriend at home, Sally Joe. She's watching. And I just wanted to make a special point because this next song could be misunderstood. This next song is called Ugly and Slouchy, That's the Way I Like Them. And it is absolutely positively not about Sally Joe. It's just an old Maddox Brothers song that we decided we wanted to start playing.
Yeah.
But I just wanted to make that disclaimer because I know she's watching out there.
It's a good song.
It is. So let's, now, again, the Maddox Brothers and Rose, hillbilly royalty, they were out here in California back in the 1940s and 1950s, and they were hugely popular. I mean, they were like the first rock concert act out here. I mean, they were drawing 3,000, 4,000, 5,000 people to come see them play, and they were just, they were crazy. All of their songs were just crazy, like this next one that we're going to do for you right now. It's called Ugly and Slouchy.
Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of them wolves hanging around. Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of her loving someone else. I've been all around this wide world, nothing I ain't seen. Well, I got me a little gal, she's a far from a being queen. Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of her loving someone else. But she wears my brand. For this little gal of mine, I'd fight most any man. Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of her loving someone else. All Xander, go.
Some pretty bass playing now, don't you think?
Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of them wolves hanging around. Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of her loving someone else. I've been all around this wide world, nothing I ain't seen. For I got me a little gal, she's a far from a being queen. Ugly and slouchy, that's the way I like them. There'll never be no fear of her loving someone else.
Very nice, very nice. That was our sort of easy listening jazz number.
That was nice. That was nice. Relaxing, that was relaxing. Yeah.
I don't think I've told my Fred Maddox story. So Fred Maddox was really one of the innovators of slap bass, that thing he was just doing. Demonstrate a little slap bass. And when I first moved out to California, and I know that Big Sandy had the same experience, Rose Maddox was still around. I saw Rose Maddox backed up by Big Sandy and the Fly Rat Boys. And for a very brief period when I first moved out here, Fred Maddox was still alive. And he was genius because he played like this on every song. That was his thing, man. But he had this early 1950s Epiphone upright bass. It was a beautiful blonde upright bass that must have cost a fortune when it was new. I take that back. It was Sunburst, now that I remember, for all the geeks out there. But he had this trick. He would play his doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo-doo, and at the end of the song, he would kick the bass with his cowboy boots. Like, that was just their thing. Like, you know, the end of the song, dun-doo-doo-doo-doo, dun-dun, dun. He would just kick the bass. And so, Robert, I don't know if you remember this, but when we got to hang out with Fred Maddox, the backside of his bass was completely caved in. And it had been reinforced with like 3,000 layers of duct tape. And he would still end every song with ding, 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 ding. That's hillbilly, man. That is real hillbilly right there. All right, let's move on here. Let's do a song right now called You Better Not Go.
One, two, three. I got to thinking last night about that old hometown of mine and of the love I left there all alone. So I packed up this morning and I caught myself a train. And now at last I'm on my way back home. But the clickety-clack up the wheels on the track say, you better not go, you better not go, you better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, you better not be going back. Well, the train rolls along and my nerves are nearly gone, for I know all the tears that I have caused. Is her love still as true, or has she found somebody new? Can I still claim her heart, or have I lost? But the clickety-clack of the wheels on the track say, you better not go, you better not go, you better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, you better not be going back. So wrong to go, and my fears seem to grow that somebody is now in my place. Well, she tell me to stay, well, she just turn away. Will she kiss me or laugh right in my face? But the clack of the wheels on the track say, you better not go, you better not go, better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, better not be going back. Well, I broke every vow, and she may hate me now, for I've known this old world for so long. But I've just got to know if she still loves me so and forgives me for doing so wrong. But the clickety-clack of the wheels on the track say, you better not go, better not go, you better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, better not be going back. Say, better not go, better not go, better not be going back.
Thank you so much. And now here's a song that I wrote. It's a little thing. Again, it's about dancing. Hopefully, we'll get back to dancing for too long. Little thing called, I'm Gonna Wear Out the Soles of My Shoes. Mm-hmm. The weather, it's throwing my guitar out of tune just a little bit.
The weather?
At least I'm gonna blame it on the weather and not my poor string maneuvering abilities.
It's not a Bixby problem.
That's right. Here we go, a little thing called Wear Out the Soles of My Shoes. Well, come on, honey, don't you let me down. This haircut, you wanna get frisky. A bartender, I'll have another shot of whiskey. Oh, baby, I just wanna rock with you, and I'll wear out the soles of my shoes. Now, Saturday night is my night to howl. The band is playing as hot as a poker. Well, I ain't trying to be a joker.
paint the whole town red. Sunday morning, just the hours away. Well, tomorrow I won't forget to pray. But tonight I ain't got nothing to lose. I'll wear out the soles of my shoes.
Thank you guys very much. Now, I think it's high time that we bring back the singing MC, Big Sandy, up here to the stage. Yeah! What do you think?
If only to warm up. How about that, though? Hey, hey.
You want me to raise that thing
up? I don't
up
know.
For
yeah. No, you don't have to do it. You're the star. Hold on. You're the star of the show.
I know, but somebody shrunk that thing. It wasn't me. There you go.
She said.
Oh,
it is cold.
It's the cold water.
And I don't know if you all knew this. There is on your way home, maybe you can make full use of this. There's a beautiful full moon tonight.
Blue moon.
Yeah. It's actually a snow moon.
Oh, nice.
And you know what? That's right. There's no moon like snow moon. All right. Yeah, right on it there. Okay. I didn't have time to plug in, but I'm told my battery's worn out, so that's fine. It's okay. Here we go. Bad news.
Yeah.
How about this? Feel free to shimmy. Slow. They all call me on Wi-Fi, 'cause everybody knows I'm bad news. Everywhere I go, always getting into trouble, and leaving little girls who hate to see me go. Lumberjack but man, they all call me on Wi-Fi. To me it's just the same, 'cause I'm bad news.
Bad news.
Everywhere I go, that's right, getting into trouble, leaving little girls who hate to see me go. Ladies and gentlemen, the one and only Mr. Deke Dickerson. Round of applause. Applausa, por favor. That was good. Well, from north to south, east to west, the story just the same. From one state to the other, I've had to change my name, 'cause I'm bad news.
Bad news.
Everywhere I go, always getting in the trouble, and leaving little girls who hate to see me go.
That's the truth.
Well, they tried to hang me up in Oakland, they did in San Francisco. Well, I wouldn't choke, I broke the rope, they had to let me go, 'cause I'm bad news. Everywhere I go, always getting in the trouble, and leaving little girls who hate to see me go. 'Cause I'm bad news. There's a full moon out tonight. That makes me even badder news. Yeah. Bad news. That was good news, I think. How about that? Round of applause for the Whippersnappers with Deke and this old Sandy fella who is just happy to get out of the cave and come out to hang out with you good people. All right. You know what, Deke? You know what I'm talking about when I say that. Over the last year or, you know, year and a half, couple years, we've lost too many, way too many of the original artists that we all look up to, whose songs we have worshipped all of our lives. Here's a song that was done by one of my heroes, Sleepy the Beef.
We had some good times with Sleepy.
We really did.
We got to play with him and hang out with him. What a guy. Sleepy the Beef was so big.
How big was he?
That when I backed him up one time and he broke a guitar string, I handed him my guitar, a big guitar, and it looked like a ukulele on him. I swear. I see pictures of him playing my guitar. I'm like, it looks like he's playing a ukulele.
Yeah, well, that is the truth. Anybody who ever stood next to him would know. Deke, you're a tall fella. He was a mountain of a man.
Yeah.
And a mountain of an artist. Here's one of his songs here. Oh, I better slap this on here. We were discussing this the other day, Deke, and it's funny. As I heard it, I said, well, I think it's a B flat. He said, no, the clip you sent me is an A. And then I went back and listened and said, Dad Gummit, I think he's right. But it's kind of like a little bit out of...
It's in micro tuning.
Yeah, all right. So let's micro tune this song right here now. What do you say?
Good. All right.
How much I love that woman of mine. How much I love that woman of mine. Oh, sweet love I'll never find. And I want her with me all the time. What would I give just to have her now? What would I give just to have her now? Will I give my life? No good, no how. If I can't have her with me all the time. Well, if you see her, tell her for me. The sugar daddy full of misery. I'm gonna see her when the sun goes down. Well, I'll be looking all over town. Cause I can't stop my crazy heart. No, I can't stop my crazy heart. Oh, and I feel just like, yeah, they're gonna break apart. If I can't have her with me all the time.
Get it! Go!
Sugar daddy full of misery. I'm gonna see you when the sun goes down. Well, I've been looking all over town. Cause I can't stop my crazy heart. No, I can't stop my crazy heart. And it feels just like they're gonna break apart. Let's keep grooving. But if I can't have her with me all the time. You got it. Sugar daddy full of misery. I'm gonna see you when the sun goes down. I've been looking all over town. Cause I can't stop my crazy heart. No, I can't stop my crazy heart. Well, head feels just like gonna play a part. If I can't have it with me all the time. Well, if I can't have it one more time. Oh yeah. If I can't have her with me all the time.
Yeah.
That's it. Oh, thank you. Ladies and gentlemen, I'm Big Sandy. This is Deke Dickerson.
Give it up for Big Sandy, y'all, the singing MC. Really appreciate it, man. Great to be up here with you.
Don't you love him? Let him know. Yeah.
We just have one more song to do. But, you know, Robert, I remembered a Sleepy LaBeef story. I'm sure you've heard this one. Sleepy LaBeef lived in Arkansas, and he toured with a, you know, 3 or 4 piece band in a 15 passenger van, right? And they would go on tour all over the United States. And Sleepy, when he wasn't touring, he would sell stuff at the local flea market in Arkansas. So what he would do is when they would play in Indianapolis, if he found like a giant car bumper, he would buy it, throw it in the van. Do you remember this at all? Because I remember them pulling into L.A. one time. They were playing at a little place called the Blue Saloon. And the van was so full of junk that he was going to sell at the flea market back in Arkansas that the band was like, they weren't able to sit in their regular seats at all. They were kind of like half on and half off. It was awesome. Yes, you remember. Rock Martin. That's right. Long time ago. All right, we got one more song left for you here tonight. Have you guys had a good time? Once again, I wanna thank Big Sandy, the singing MC. I wanna thank Christopher Burkhardt and all the people working here for Seller's shows, for putting on these events and letting us experience some live music in a safe and socially distant atmosphere. I wanna thank the people here at Campus Jack's for allowing us to do these shows here in their backyard pavilion. And I want to thank all the people that are watching online. I know that we've got people all over the globe that are tuning into this show, and I hope that they've had a good time watching it, too. We're going to send you home right now with a song that features all the whippersnappers. It's a little thing called Charmin' Betsy. Yay.
1, 2, 3. Rich girl rides in a big fine car. Poor girl does the same. My girl rides in a Model T Ford, but she gets there just the same. Coming round the mountain, Charmin' Betsy, get her, boy. Coming round the mountain, Coralie, poor thing. And if I never see her again, good gal, remember me.
I'll go first.
Rich girl wears her expensive perfume. Poor girl does the same. My girl don't wear no perfume at all, but you can smell her just the same. Coming round the mountain, Charmin' Betsy, get her, boy. Coming round the mountain, Coralie, poor thing. And if I never see her again, remember me.
One more time for Bert Evelos, y'all.
My girl sleeps in a fine feather bed. Poor girl does the same. My girl sleeps in our old outhouse, but she snoozes just the same. Coming round the mountain, Charmin' Betsy, get her, boy. Coming round the mountain, Coralie, poor thing. And if I never see her again,
Sander,
remember me. Charmin' Betsy,
get her, boy.
Come around the mountain, Coralie, poor thing. And if I never see her again, good gal, remember me.
Thank you so much, friends. I'm Dick Dickerson. These are the Whippersnappers.
Hey-o, how about that? Dick Dickerson and the Whippersnappers. Yeah. Oh, we have a standing ovation forming in the back. Once again, Dick Dickerson and the Whippersnappers. Fantastic. And as one who knows, I can say this for sure. It's been very strange when it comes to the shows or the lack thereof. You get in a certain groove and then it's gone. These guys are playing as if they've been playing every night for the last year. Give a round of applause. Dick Dickerson and the Whippersnappers. All right. Well, I'm told there's no time for an encore, but we do want your one more round of applause for Dick Dickerson and the Whippersnappers. Thank you for coming out here tonight. Those of you at home, think of these guys when you make your donations. There's still time for that. All right, now I'd like to bring up the man who makes all these shows possible, puts them all together. He's going to talk to you about some other upcoming shows. This is Christopher Burkhardt. I'm Big Sandy. Thank you. Here's Christopher.
Our singing MC. Big Sandy. Dick Dickerson, everybody. What a great show, huh? Man, oh man, oh man, I love these guys. Hey, I want to tell you real quick about some upcoming shows we've got. One is tomorrow at noon. We're going to do the retrospective on our Eclectic American Roots show. So tune in at noon. It's an online streaming show. Stellar shows and concerts where most of you are watching right now. And at noon, we're going to recap the whole last year of our shows and pull out the best bits and samples and segments. And, of course, our video host is Big Sandy. We've had Dick Dickerson host several times. He'll be part of the show. So it's going to be a lot of fun. Noon Pacific time, Stellar Shows and Concerts on Facebook. Also on YouTube. And then on the 19th of March, right here on this stage and in this audience, we have Lizzie and the Triggermen doing a tribute to the Ladies of Swing. So don't miss that one. And then if you still want a little more rockabilly, we got the Rockin' Rebels coming on March 26th. They'll be here on the stage. They'll be live streaming too, so don't miss any of that stuff. It's going to be great. So we'll see you all back here then. Thanks for coming. Let's get out of here. Thank you, Campus Jacks. Thank you, waiters and waitresses. And thank you for watching. Bye-bye.